make things out of wood, all sorts of things. And it normally starts with an idea, a brief fleeting idea in the mind, and then off you go, start the process of realising that as an object. And I work with wood because it's an abundant material in Tasmania. Once you start making one piece, two pieces, out of those pieces comes the combination of lots of possibilities. But when you start heading off towards making something, you must stick to that course. The design drives everything. If you're not in control of the design, you can get lost again. So the design is the most important part. It's like a roadmap of where you're going to. Tasmanian timber is very important, not only because it's your local material and you can access it easily, but Tasmanian timber, we're blessed that we've got a variety of colours and grains where in a small geographical area. Normally, to get a variety, you could travel quite long distances that we can get locally. To make something out of your local material is probably a real driver to creating wealth. And it doesn't matter whether the piece is small or large, but it's that conversion of a local raw material into a manufactured product. It's creating a wealth that you can't lose. Once you've created that object, you've added value to it. And by doing that, you've created some sort of wealth that people can use and recycle and hand on. But at that point, you're making that what was just a commodity of the timber into a product. The Tasmanian brand's very interesting because it's starting to create its own strong identity. It's to do with location, you know, isolation, a different type of weather, climate, all of those things, and I think they're all starting to add up to something that's really strongly identifiable. And hopefully if you live and work in Tasmania and you manufacture product here, well, you can piggyback on that concept that is Tasmania. Recently, I've just invested in some computer-aided equipment which has enabled me to manufacture small product. The tasks of manufacturing a small product in volume are very repetitive, and that takes the human boredom factor out of it. It takes some time to work through the whole product from start to end and get it flawless so you can guarantee the same result every time. But it's very, very important in a manufacturing sense to have a capacity for high volume at some point, and hopefully, given a period of time, that expertise will develop to making larger objects in a mass-produced or volume product. But just at the moment, I'm concentrating on the smaller products to develop that expertise. The new little product is a little box to put business cards in, and it's made from solid timber, but the whole set of processes around it, cutting the lid right next to the base so that all the grain matches up, which gives it a stability. Timber moves all the time, expands and contracts, and making the lid open and close smoothly for forever is a challenge. Hopefully this little box will be treasured by someone, and it'll be a piece of Tasmanian timber in someone's life.